was 2 days before he died.
It was October 26th, 2015. From Central Prison in Raleigh, North Carolina, Pazuzu Algarad sent his mother, Cynthia, this letter.
He always said, "Mom," of course. And Shaka Muku, which means what's up in Arabic. And he says, "I'm so bored. Got a letter from you and one from Amber. I despise the human race. People are ugly and pointless creatures. I sit back and watch them and they anger me. I should get a medal for murdering these stupid Maybe when I'm dead, the gods of chaos shall grant me the power." I mean, he was so hurt and angry, you know. And so, "How's things your way? When are you and Kim coming to see me again?" "Well, I'm hungry and tired, so I'll write you again here soon. I love you."
2 days later, he was dead, ruled a suicide, his cause of death, blood loss from a deep wound to a major blood vessel in his left arm. The autopsy revealing tattoos that had largely gone unseen to the public, some reading Pazuzu, Lucifer, Satan, Villain, 666, Joker, Live Fast and Die. Today, Pazuzu's forensic evaluation from his accessory after the fact conviction is providing insight into how his mind functioned.
They're very sensational, these cases, but they're very rare.
Psychiatrist Dr. Phil Levine says Pazuzu's schizotypal personality disorder would have led him to experience unusual perceptual experiences, odd thinking or speech, to be suspicious, paranoid.
I can't connect up from a schizotypal personality structure to murders.
Levine says mental illness is a separate problem from people who become violent.
This case is much different, I think. It's a real outlier.
Adding he wouldn't have responded well to medications.
He had alcohol problems for a long time, and then he started getting into methamphetamines, which is not likely to help him, but to make his anxiety issues worse.
Do you think there are other people like him out there?
There are. They're not common.
I feel like I failed him. I mean, I would give him the world.
Today, Pazuzu's remains are in Cynthia's living room.
I think that I loved him too much, and then, you know, I said, "Okay, whatever you want to do."
Less than an hour away,
her daddy was a stallion named Rolling Stone.
Stacy Carter, lit by a golden hue, dragonflies representing transformation circling overhead.
It's just recent they've appeared, and I don't know why.
Reflects on the day she learned Pazuzu had killed himself.
I didn't really feel much, honestly. I wasn't surprised. I never knew the guy.
The day she met Pazuzu's mother.
I don't think she's evil. I think things got out of hand. She lost control, and then she was terrorized. She was powerless.
The day she met the father of her child.
And we just started talking, and it was just like, I mean, just magnetic.
And on the back of a peaceful creature.
My life's work has become about horses and teaching people, giving people that opportunity.
She hopes people will learn.
I would like to see prevention.
From what led to her now 15-year-old son having to grow up without a father at the hands of a man who fancied himself a mythical beast.
You take somebody like Pazuzu and you can blow him off and you can say, you know what, he's a loser, you know, he's a loser, who cares? But if we don't help and do something in those situations, it affects everybody.
Michael Hennessy, Fox 8 News.
Amber Birch and Crystal Matt.